God's word everywhere else, basically. So, progress so far. Assessment of user requirements was done last year. We made a rather lengthy and detailed questionnaire, and we got about 1,500 feelings. So basically, about 80% of our user base was assessed. Not everyone responded, but that's fine. So migrations started by the end of last year as a result of this assessment. And training and user support happens continuously for those that are selected for migration. We have also an update schedule, so we are deploying the community version of the office. Always the 12 or 4 in mind of these. And for deployment, we use the Microsoft Software Center. I don't know this abbreviation. So SCCM. It's a standard Microsoft solution for deploying software. All of the infrastructure is based on Microsoft solutions, so we use those as well. We have still a few open questions that we cannot, or we have not answered. So what do we do with our open question? I think email is still a very important part of the work in the ministries. They use it a lot. Also, calendars, address books, scheduling of meetings, so that must work as well. We also have a link, and we need really something in the office online, but we are still searching possible candidates on the that has the office online and is better than SharePoint. Rather than a common file share that is used by many groups in the ministries as tool of collaboration. So probably extensive uses of SharePoint won't be start, but against the file share we can provide something like the Nextcloud or OnCloud or something like that. That has online editing for collaboration. But that is still under investigation. So, results of the assessment, that's really interesting. So, we have a methodology to plan the assessment. So, key was that we should migrate only those people who can do their job with the office as well. If they cannot do their job, then it's all pointless. We know that there are problems with interoperability, so let's ask about those problems. If someone is feeling that they are affected by those problems, give them a look. Also, to not have everyone marking every single tick box on the questionnaire, we asked for documents that are showing an example of that feature being used on their daily work. Some of their users actually provided this. So we have about 2,000 documents uploaded, and we can dissect those for features that need to be used. And also, the idea was that we ask people what are the problems and later we fix those problems so they can might be migrated at a later point. This is very important because LibreOffice can be improved and issues very conservative environment. People will do everything, including their best, to avoid migration. So we ask them, what's your problem? They will answer very precisely to this question. This is a very good question, I think. They will show us every single possible problem they can. But what they don't know, we can't cause those problems. And so we are without weapons against us at a later point. So this is the methodology. What are the areas that we considered problematic in the world? These are the winners. So by 62% of the people said that they are using change tracking on their daily job. And by dissecting those documents, we found that 91% is true of that 62%. So it's really, really important. Document comparison came out second, we cannot really check that. So it's just like a feature of presentation documents, so there is no conflict for that. Of course, charts is very, very popular, really popular. Then we asked for extra table embedding. They think it's used, but actually it's not. So that's the 12% hit rate. So we have also ships and Myanmar and the rest as well as very important features. I'm not sure if you will be able to fix like smart art or informationized management as well. It's a little out of it, but we can start with these. Also, we have the same chart or same table for Excel. In Excel, charts are very, very popular feature. Also, cell styles are very, very popular. They love to cover their cells. I guess other people like that as well. So, protection, ship protection is very important. Pivot table. I would not have imagined that they are using pivot tables in the ministry, but apparently they do. Just like conditional formatting and information management. Macros are and form controls are quite behind in this program map. Also, we should have asked about share for goods. It's like the feature when you upload this workbook to a file share or SharePoint and edit formally with your colleagues. And when you see it, it synchronizes back to this file share or SharePoint. It's very important feature. And we don't support that. So, we also had a very simple tick box system at the end of the assessment. Basically, we just ask people about what are the areas on the ribbon in Word and in Excel that you are using a lot. So it's just feature categories, because there is a lot of such categories. In total, there was like 70 photos, so 70 tick boxes are quite a lot for a simple questionnaire. So we did not go into details more than that. And all these basic functionalities, we consider those that are marked by more than 70% of the questionnaires. So these are the very basic features that are virtually used by everyone. We can say that above 70% quality they are not daily. And so interoperability on these areas is and he said that you can use the bell, it's just fine, and you don't expect it to do more than an American typewriter can do. If you use it like a typewriter, it's fine. Just they don't use it like a typewriter. So here is that. Also, if you go to the Valsera, you can find metabugs about all some interoperability. And those look scary because there is a lot of dependency bugs, numbers as such. But we try to find more and more bugs on top of that, but it's already in Valsera. Not that easy. Like 70 or 80% of possible bugs is already there. We are methodologically finding more and more, like taking one item from this basic functionality feature types, feature categories, like every single possible checkbox and setting that is offered by Microsoft Office, and 2010, most people use that. We try to use that feature, check if it breaks. If it breaks, we report it. And it's not that easy to find new bugs on top of what is already in the bugs there. Also, we have a rough idea of what is really important regarding the interoperability of those features. We have a bug list, like a to-do list, of bugs that we need to fix. And we have about 300 bugs on that. And I estimate that after finishing this interoperability check-ins, the setting of uploaded documents, we may have twice of that, which is really important and really hurting bugs, but it's just like this amount, not really terrible. Okay, once more, I wanted to split this. So this is the writer labels metabug and its dependencies. It's like a lot, but it will be a really hard time to find anything more than these 70 or 80 bugs that are still open. So our work is just this much, pretty easy. Okay, so let's talk about user experience. So we are deploying LibreOffice to selected users and everyone else as well. Because we had another decision that said we must deploy to everyone in the ease domain. So user tries LibreOffice. They open the document that we yesterday got. Let's define the user experience. Let's go back to 2004. This is Firefox 1.0 from Wikipedia. And Mozilla in 2004 realized something very important, that regarding their users, the part of the window on top is not user experience. That's not the important part of user experience. The really important part of user experience is the content part of the browser. So this is what I'm talking about. This is the same thing I will talk about in regarding user experience. So user tries without S6 and what does they see? It's a simple feature to mark document as final. Invert. When you open this link, LibreOffice, nothing happens. Interesting user experience, I call it rather embarrassing. but not anymore. Like in 6.1, this is fixed, thanks to us. So, more user experience. Those paragraphs have styles. Alignment is defined in styles. It should inherit. The second paragraph should inherit the styles, the alignment from the styles. But user opens it in LibreOffice, it's not inherited. Interesting user experience, rather inconvenient. Also, we have this beautiful invitation letter. With a little bit of space in Microsoft Office between these paragraphs, and a little bit more, just to make it unreadable in LibreOffice. Very interesting user experience. This is from Maxilla, so I highlighted that originally there was zero spacing, but LibreOffice somehow invented a little bit more than that. More user experience from LibreOffice. User somehow creates a very simple table. Actually, it was not very simple, it was 6 pages before we reduced it. And somehow they put this interesting character into the table, which makes the whole table fall apart, just like this. It turned out that there was a little bit of an interesting that was understood by Word, but not by LibreOffice. Unfortunately, this is also fixed by Lasso, so thanks again. More user experience. When you have changed the king in Word, you can move paragraphs. Cut, paste. It was a little bit unfast by LibreOffice, so in real life the cut paragraph appeared as uncut paragraph, which is a really embarrassing user experience when this happens in a contract, just like spotted by our user. In a contract that is being modified by multiple parties. So it's rather embarrassing user experience that we are providing to them. But thanks to Lasso, this is also fixed by LibreOffice 6.1 or so. My favorite is our simple name card that you can fold into by the vertical axis of the paper, put it in the table before the very important person. But you cannot do this currently in LibreOffice. Rather embarrassing user experience, don't you agree? So we need to improve this kind of user experience. And just like I said, it is possible. We think that actual user expectation is interoperability with OXML, no matter what. People in the ministry are connected with a lot of other people outside world. Sometimes the other department next door, sometimes the other ministry, sometimes the company in the private sector, or municipalities, government offices, and so on and so on. Everyone is communicating with the other outside world. So we cannot put anyone into a ODF bundle of interoperability, which is also interoperability. Also, even if we do, users expect that they should be able to work with the same files that they worked yesterday. If those fall apart, that's very bad. creating documents. So if we have a person working 1 hour for creating a document, and they usually spend more than that, then that document has a value that can be sold us as money. So time spent on creation multiplied by the user's age. And sometimes these are these documents are created by multiple people, very people. So those documents are developed a lot, and more actually than a single license or 5 licenses. So we cannot waste those efforts that are still put in
to
the documents.
No.
And also we cannot ask people to spend even more efforts to make those documents slightly similar to what they have manually, because that will not scale very well in the times of thousands of users. That will not scale. But that will use is that XML is everywhere. Well, when I started to work on this project, 2016, it was just like talks in the ministry when we were planning the government decision. So there was a little bit of exchange of opinions that happened in 2016. So I went there with the Document Foundation opinion that everyone should use ODF. Everyone should use ODF because OSMS support sucks. You cannot work with this, right? You cannot work. Everything falls apart. Okay, they said there was a little bit of exchange of opinions. I went to do this, came out with this. So they said we either improve the OSMS support or there won't be any project anymore. Because if I say we need to use ODF, the project starts here before the government decision or anything. So I was forced kind of to love OXML and start working. So that's why we are using it, we continue to use it. And basically, from user perspective, open software is just a tool for work, to create a beautiful document, that is content-wise correct documents, just as we did. No one cares about different office documents and the standards and the user numbers. Neither do the post errors. Also, the interoperability is a voluntary goal, because complete migration is not a goal of this government decision. The goal of this government decision is vendor independence. So they won't say that they want 100% in office, because that way they would 100% depend on our budget and our infrastructure. That's not what they want either. So they don't want to entirely depend on Microsoft, don't want to entirely depend on us. So competition continues. So we need interoperability in the long term. and also there is always, just like I said earlier, an outside one that we need to collaborate with. Like public organizations, publicly owned organizations like state companies, schools, hospitals, there are private companies, they can be forced to use LibreOffice. They cannot be forced to install LibreOffice because they are sovereign entities, so they can say no. The government has a little bit of power, so they can say that the ministries should gradually introduce LibreOffice. But that's all they can say. They cannot force this to municipalities, hospitals, schools, private companies. Just turn the whole. So we need to support OSMN better. Also, all the extra support in Microsoft is similar and I know that all of them who are similar support. And we cannot even have that. So we just can just possibly live with that. So in this regard, all the other countries in Europe as an interoperability tool. I can show you this very only presentation in PowerPoint. What do you think? Will it fall apart? Will the colors be off? Yes, thank you. I'm checking. But we are in a lucky position because OXMS support me in the office. And that's our reference in this way. So we are arriving in the box and improving situation. So we need to improve situation, so our problem is how we do that. We are building a Windows 13. Fortunately, we had the luck to contract Laszlo for our senior developer. And he's mentoring a few junior developers. I also saw Laszlo's work yesterday, or if you were watching it on YouTube. This team is very young. We start lecture work just in July. But we have plans to expand because we have the means and approval to hire more people. So far, we are in a good start. And also, we have plans to fix up the basic interoperability features. Paragraph settings, balance numbering, and tables involved. Those are very basic, and our experience so far shows that it is possible. So, about a little bit of results, it's only 3 months of work, but paragraph formatting is now mostly okay. We are lucky that Justin Root has started to work on this metabug as well. Its number is here. And those are the dependencies. And what you can see is that most of it is already fixed. And the rest is not really important or even miscategorized. So we have that. So paragraph formatting, those are spacing and indentations are now mostly okay. We have some chart fixes coming. Junior developers, Balázs and Adam, are working on chart support because it's a pretty buggy area. There is a lot to learn, and they can basically learn everything by fixing up chart export and import support for OXML. And so, more numbers. In the last 3 months, with a team of 3 people, we fixed about 30 bugs. And I think it's a rather nice number, and we are still continuing to work in the long term. Earlier I said that there is about 600 bugs it needs to be fixed. I'm not sure that we will have time for all of that, for the experience, but we will cross that bridge once we are there. So, but we recommend this, doing this to others. So, building internal competence is a very good idea, especially if you are in a larger organization like we are. So with the appropriate amount of resources. If you are a municipality level, it's okay if you are not able to finance developer team. There are support companies, starting with C, that can help. And even if you are able to funnel a few thousand euros to them, they will move down and for that, and if you are doing this together, you can get there. Then OXML support is not perfect, and not every link feature is supported. But what is really important, those will be regarding in the long term, or not even so long term. Also, one more idea, you should not panic, because Microsoft Office was not invented by aliens from space like this. It was actually made by this guy, Charles Schumann. So he's a Hungarian genius. So whatever he did, you can do it after him. Not because we are geniuses, because we are Hungarians. So thanks for your attention.